Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Jennifer Taylor, and today we are going to talk about interval data analysis. So this includes Likert scales. So interval data is data that's measured on a scale where each point is an equal distance from one another. And a Likert scale is an interval scale where instead of number ratings like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it uses labels on the data points from it might be extremely agree to extremely disagree, extremely satisfied to extremely dissatisfied, extremely important to extremely unimportant. But the data is labeled, and then SPSS goes and puts numbers associated with those intervals. So how do we analyze this data? Well, I'm going to walk you through a four-step process. We're going to start with step one, where we identify your interval data. And then we're going to move on to step two, where we're going to create the descriptive statistics, including mean and standard deviation, median and mode. Then we're going to create an Excel file where we save our descriptives and create a frequency file. And then in step four, we're going to create a chart, so that you're going to have everything you need to be able to present on the data. So let's get started. I have the group two data here, and we're going to start with step one, which is identifying the data that is interval data. And so let's take a look. I'm going to open up the labels. Values. All right, so this first question is nominal. We have not important to extremely important. That would be a Likert scale, and you can see how SPSS assigns number ratings to it. But in the survey, people only see not at all, slightly, moderately, very, and extremely important. And as this group has done, they have made sure that their not at all important is, which is more negative, is on the lower end of the scale, and the extremely important, which is the most positive, is on the highest level of the scale. So they've done a good job recoding their scales, because originally SPSS reverse codes it the other way. All right, so that is an interval scale. And so all of these, all of Q2 all the way to Q12, all of those are interval scales. The check all that can apply is nominal data, multi-response nominal data. Okay, and so this one, once a year, three or four times a year, every other month, once a month. If this is ordinal data, it's categories, and there's not an equal distance between the rankings. Like if this was 1 to 2 times a year, 3 to 4 times a year, 5 to 6 times a year, 7 to 8, 9 to 10, 10, 11 to 12, so they would have equal distance between the scales if we did it that way, then that would make it interval data. But because it's unequal, it makes it ordinal. So that's not what we're looking for. Check all that apply here. So nominal, check all that apply, nominal. Here we go. And satisfied to dissatisfied. Extremely dissatisfied to extremely satisfied. And again, this group did a really good job making sure that the scale points were recoded. And so this one would be a Likert scale, and that makes it an interval data. So question 12 would qualify. Let's see. Strongly disagree. Somewhat disagree. Neither. Somewhat agree. Strongly agree. And so this would be another Likert scale. Now, there's probably more interval or Likert scales, but I'm going to let the group go through and figure that out. But what I'm going to do for this analysis is I'm going to focus on question 12, which was the satisfied. How satisfied are you with the deaf and hard of hearing center? So let's go into step two for this question, which is create the descriptive statistics, including mean, standard deviation, median, and mode. So we're going to go to analyze. We're going to go to descriptives. We're going to go to frequencies. And we're going to scroll down here and try and find that question. How satisfied are you? Click on statistics. And you want mean, median, mode. And we also want standard deviation. Now, what standard deviation tells us is how dispersed the data is. And so we'll talk about this more when we pull up the data. Okay, and then we have our data. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. We have our sample. We had 15 people that answered the question, and we have 26 people who did not answer the question. So it looks like we have a relatively high dropout rate in our survey. But of the 15 people who answered it, we have a mean of 4.53. So it was a 5-point scale. And so most people were extremely satisfied. And that is a very good thing to hear for the center. The median was a 5 and the mode was a 5. So on a 5-point scale, 50% marker, the right dab in the middle, it was a 5. And then the mode, the frequency that had the most was extremely satisfied, this number 5. Now, a standard deviation, this tells us the amount of variation in a set of data values. And on a normal curve, so when we looked at those normal curves a while ago, and we looked at the frequencies with the histogram charts, well, this standard deviation is going to tell us that if you take this mean and you add or subtract 0.64 from it, so I add or subtract, that 68% of the data is going to be within one standard deviation of the data. So add and subtract add or subtract this, and then you'll get the range where 68% of the data occurs. If you times this by 2 and then you subtract, add and subtract it to the mean, then you're going to have 2 standard deviations, and that's going to include 95% of the data. And if you multiply it by 3 and add and subtract, you're going to get 99.7% of the data. So really what this tells us is, what's the variation? If this number is larger, then that typically signifies that we could possibly have some issues within the data. So it's just something to keep an eye on. All right, so we have our frequencies. We have a high system missing, but we had 15 people who answered this. All right, so let's move on to step 3, which is creating the Excel file. I'm going to open an Excel file. And for you, you should have a worksheet that you're working on. And I would just add this to whatever big worksheet you have. And so I would rename this. We're working on, I do believe it's question 12. So satisfied with the center. I'm going to copy this, go over. I like to paste it special so that there's no formatting. I'm going to go back over. I want to capture this as well. I'm going to put it in my Excel file. And I'm going to paste special. Now, I just like to highlight what I'm going to report in my presentation just so that I can easily catch it with my eye. As far as this is concerned, we need to make a chart. Now, we only want to report on the number of people who answered this survey. So nobody said dissatisfied at all, which is really good news. We do have one person who is neither dissatisfied or satisfied, but we want to report based off of 15. And if you take these numbers, and so say you take this, let's go here and equal, you take that and you divide it by 15, which is our sample, you're going to find that it gives you this number right here, this valid percent. So the valid percent only accounts for the people who took the survey, and this is what we want to report on. So again, we want to turn this into a percentage. So let's just simply take this and go equal this divided by 15, which is our total, and then we want to turn it into a percent, and we want one decimal place, and sorry, we shouldn't have gone down there. All right, because now for our chart, we're going to move on to the last part, which is create a chart. We are going to click on, we actually need to, for the chart for this, we need to include the other two. And so it was, so, and there was 0 and 0, and that's 0 and 0, and that's 0 and 0. So we will make that a percentage. Okay, and so now we want to take these five scales. We want to click control and do our valid percent. And then we want to click insert, click on the chart, pick this one, and this is what you get. So we want to change the chart title. We want to format the plot area, get rid of those axes lines, put the data labels, and there you go. Oops. Now, when you go to report for your presentation, you will have this chart, and you will also be reporting above it the mean, median, mode. You report the mean, and I'll show you this in class later, but you report the mean with the standard deviation in parentheses after it, and then you repeat the median and mode. But there you have it, everything you need to be able to report on your survey for interval data. So I hope you enjoyed learning about it, and I will talk to you later. Bye.